we will now examine a three-part CBC analyzer. Parts of the CBC analyzer includes display or the graphic screen, where menu and functions are displayed. In the menu display, we can see bars for the sample ID number, the mode, analyzing status, which shows the actual process status like ready, analyzing, rinsing, etc. Result of the complete blood count on the screen, print option, description, and paper feed. The keyboard panel shows numeric keys, navigation keys, and shortcut keys. Numeric keys are used to enter sample ID and quality control values. The navigation keys are used to navigate the equipment menu. The sample number key is used to select the sample number for editing. Enter is used to fix the selected menu. Select key helps you to open menu tree for further options. Mode helps to select the sample mode, which could be the whole blood mode or the pre-dilution mode. Help key is used when error has occurred. Shutdown is used to shut down the machine. Probe. Probe is used for aspirating the sample, the quality control material, or for the maintenance purpose. The start button. This switch starts the whole blood mode analysis and the pre-diluted mode analysis. Trap chamber prevents the reagent, etc., from flowing into the vacuum pump of the compressor when an error occurs with the instrument. Waste chamber. It collects waste from the transducers and mixing chambers. Detector block. It incorporates the RBC transducer, the WBC transducer, and the hemoglobin flow cell, the sample rotor valve, and the sample rotor valve tray. The sample rotor valve makes volumetric measurements of aspirated blood. Operation. Samples. As per the sample collection guidelines, whole blood is collected in EDTA anticoagulated tubes. EDTA tubes can be of two types, K2 EDTA and K3 EDTA. In K2 EDTA tube, anticoagulant is in the form of a dry powder. Hence, after collection, the tube must be inverted several times to mix the blood and the anticoagulant properly. In K3 EDTA tube, the anticoagulant is in a liquid form. This enables easier mixing of the blood and the anticoagulant. However, blood collected in the K3 EDTA tubes has a tendency to produce more artifacts, especially in the mean corpuscular volume when the sample is run. Hence, K2 EDTA tubes are preferred. Always check the anticoagulant in the K3 tubes before taking blood sample. If the anticoagulant is absent or spills out, the sample will clot. Reagents used in this machine. Lysing solution, for example, stromatolyzer. This reagent lyses the RBCs for accurate counting of white blood cells and hemoglobin level measurements. In this case, the expiry of the lysing solution is 90 days from the day of opening. Please check expiry of reagent on the label or from your manufacturer. Therefore, the date of opening the reagent should always be noted on the bottle. Various pictograms on the bottle indicate the storage and handling conditions for the reagent. Follow them diligently. The lysing solution should be maintained at a temperature of 2 to 35 degrees centigrade. Diluent, for example, cell pack, is an isotonic solution used for appropriate dilution for cell count, stabilizes the cell membrane and conducts current as cells pass through aperture and focus in one stream. In this case, the expiry of diluent is 60 days from the date of opening. The date of opening of the reagent should always be noted on the bottle. Multiple pictograms, once again on the reagent carton, indicate the storage and handling conditions of the reagent. The cell pack is usually maintained at a temperature of 5 to 30 degrees centigrade. Cleaning solution, for example, Cell Clean. It is used to clean the instrument. It removes residuals of lysing reagent, cellular residues, and blood proteins from the hydraulic systems, detector block, block aspiration tube, and flow cell. It is used at the time of shutdown and special maintenance. All reagents come with a material safety data sheet or the MSDS sheet, which should be read carefully and filed. It gives information on composition and instruction for handling, storage, first aid, and managing any adverse incident due to the reagent. In addition to the above, five-part analyzer use some additional reagents for the differential count. In some five-part analyzers, fluorescent dyes are used to stain cells differentially for measurement. In others, reagents are used to stabilize the cells for identification without the aid of fluorescent dye, as in volume conductivity scatter technology. For all reagents, always check the lot number and expiry at the time of receiving and before opening the reagent. Note the stability of the reagent after opening and follow the manufacturer's instruction for storage and handling. Documents and records for the reagents should be maintained, which may include the relevant MSDS sheets for each reagent, reagent insert files, reagent opening records, and indent records. Let us now start operating the machine. Before the machine is turned on, inspect the reagents, inspect the connection of tubings and cords to see that they are not broken and the power cord is properly plugged in the outlet. Inspect the trap chamber for any waste. Trap chamber indicates the hydraulic and vacuum status of the equipment. There should be no fluid in the chamber. Please note, if fluid is found, call the technical support. Do not open the trap chamber. Inspect if the printer paper is sufficient for the day's print. Wear your protective equipment. Standard precautions are to be exercised at all times while handling samples, equipment sampling, and maintenance. Now, switch on the machine. Startup process begins, and this usually takes 4 to 5 minutes. In the startup process, machine will do a self-check analysis of internal parts to check whether they are working properly or not. Availability of the reagents, replenish if required, and the scheduled maintenance. Procedure. Do the maintenance first as per the manufacturer's guideline. If any other maintenance is due, the machine will display the message on the screen. Here, the machine shows the message, clean the transducer. The operator will have to proceed with cleaning the transducer first before the machine can be run for the day. Further details of cleaning the transducer are discussed later in this section. Background check. Auto rinse is done 3 to 5 times automatically by the machine, followed by background check. Check the background limits. They should be within the permissible limits set by the manufacturer. Here, the TLC count or the WBC count is 0.1 into 10, which means 100 cells per microliter, indicating the machine is giving an error of 100 cells in the total white blood cell count for each sample. This falls within the prescribed limit of 0.3 into 10 or 300 cells per microliter. The lab, however, can decide the tolerance limit based upon the patient population tested, as this error may be high for patients on chemotherapy. Every lab needs to understand and specify its tolerance limit and adhere to it on daily basis. Stick the background limits of all the parameters next to the machine and maintain the daily records of the same. If the background count of any parameter falls out of these limits, the message "background error" is displayed with an alarm sound. Auto-rinse then should be repeated 3 to 5 times. Machine may give background count errors due to reasons like dirty aperture, dirty flow cells, air bubbles in the probe, or faulty reagents due to bacterial growth or contamination. At this stage, please go through the help menu and take corrective action as displayed. It is important that any corrective action taken is properly documented in a corrective action log for future reference. In case the equipment shows error message, follow the required corrective measure in maintenance and perform auto-rinse and background check. If the machine shows no error in self-analysis, the machine is ready for analysis. Run the QC, the quality control. After quality control, run the patient sample. Collect the sample as per sample collection guidelines. Mix the sample gently by inverting the tube 8 to 10 times and place the sample on the rotor mixer for 3 to 5 minutes. After that, take the sample from the rotor and keep inverting gently till aspiration. In this equipment, the samples can be run in two modes, the whole blood mode and the pre-dilution mode. Your equipment also may have these options. Please check with your manufacturer. Whole blood mode is the mode of analyzing the sample in the whole blood status, whereas the pre-diluted mode is used to analyze small amount of blood, for example, from a pediatric patient, which has been collected from the earlobe or fingertip. In this mode, blood sample is diluted 1 in 26 times before analysis. We will demonstrate sample processing in both the modes. The whole blood mode. Confirm the ready status. Press mode key to display the change mode screen. Select whole mode. Press enter to change the analysis mode and return to the analysis screen. Enter the sample number by pressing the number keys and press enter. Now the machine is ready for analysis. Place the sample on the rotor mixer for 3 to 5 minutes. Take sample from the rotor mixer. Mix gently by inverting. Remove the cap carefully, taking care not to scatter the blood. Set the tube to sample probe and press the start button. The buzzer sounds twice, and when the screen displays analyzing, remove the tube carefully by lowering it straight down to avoid bending the probe. Do not remove tube when screen shows aspirating. If you remove while aspirating, air can enter, giving erroneous results. The sample probe is automatically rinsed, so there is no need to wipe it clean. When the LCD screen displays ready, prepare the next sample and repeat the procedure. Pre-diluted mode. It is used in cases where sample volume is less, like pediatric samples or capillary blood sample. The dilution is predetermined and the machine gives calculated result directly. No calculation factor needs to be applied. The pre-diluted mode in this machine, sample is diluted into 1:26 before analysis. Take 500 microliter of diluent in an Eppendorf tube using a pipette. Next, add 20 microliter of well-mixed whole blood sample using a pipette into the Eppendorf tube. Mix well using the pipette. Close the cap and mix by gently inverting the Eppendorf tube several times. Confirm the ready status. Press mode key to display the change mode screen and select the pre-dilution mode. Press enter to change the analysis mode and return to the analysis screen. Enter the sample number by pressing the sample number key and enter to fix the sample number. Now, the machine is ready for analysis. Mix the sample sufficiently by gently inverting the tube 8 to 10 times. Remove the plug, taking care not to scatter the blood. Set the tube to sample probe and press the start switch. The buzzer sounds twice, and when the screen displays analyzing, remove the tube carefully by lowering it straight down. The sample probe is automatically rinsed, so there is no need to wipe it clean. When the screen displays ready, prepare the next sample and repeat the procedure. Please note, run the sample in the pre-diluted mode within 30 minutes of dilution. Otherwise, the platelets will clump and give erroneous results. The differential and absolute counts will not be displayed in this mode. The result values are confined only to 8 parameters. Interpretation of results. Go through the results either from the screen or from the printout. The results include patient ID, date, time of processing sample, and mode. The value of parameters, both analytical and calculated parameters, are displayed. Here, the white blood cell count is showing 8.9 into 10 to the power 3 per microliter, which means 8,900 cells per microliter. The red blood cell count is 3.53 into 10 to the power 6 microliter. Hemoglobin is 10.5 grams per deciliter. The HCT or hematocrit is given as a percentage. Here it is 30.5%. MCV or the mean corpuscular volume is 86.4 femtoliter. MCH or the mean corpuscular hemoglobin is 29.7 picogram. MCHC or mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration is 34.4 gram per deciliter. The platelet count is 2.8 lakh platelets per microliter. The lymphocyte percentage is 42.2% lymphocytes of the total leukocyte count. Mixed percent is 8.9% of the total leukocyte count. Neutrophil percent is 48.9%. Lymphocyte hash is the absolute count of lymphocyte, which is calculated using the total WBC count. That is 42.2 into 8.9 upon 100, which gives 3.8 into 10 to the power 3 microliter or 3,800 lymphocytes per microliter. Similarly, the mixed cell and neutrophil absolute counts are also calculated. The RDW is the red cell distribution width, which can be set as CV percent or as standard deviation. RDW increases in anisocytosis. The PDW or the platelet distribution width is 12.4 femtoliter. The platelet distribution width is high in the rapid turnover of platelets as seen in dengue. The MPV is the mean platelet volume, which is 10.7 femtoliter. The histograms or graphs of the red blood cell count, white blood cells, and the platelets can be seen. In this machine, only the last histogram can be seen. Therefore, the previous runs must be stored as hard copies. Sometimes, flags can appear with the result, as explained later. shut down. At the end of the day, shutdown process should be followed by the operator. Do not switch off the machine without performing these procedures. Press the shutdown key. Aspirate the cell clean will be displayed on the screen. Open the cap of the cell clean reagent. Set the cell clean reagent vial to the sample probe and press the start button. Cleaning process occurs automatically for about 5 minutes. After completing the process, shutdown will be displayed on the screen. Now, switch off the machine. Storage and discarding of samples. As per regulations, labs are required to store samples for defined time duration for repeat testing if required. All CBC samples should be stored for 24 hours at 2 to 8 degrees centigrade as per the NABL 112. The labs also need to validate the adequacy of sample storage requirements like temperature and time duration by repeating sample studies. The percentage difference between the runs 24 hours apart should be acceptable as per the lab-defined criteria. The procedure for storage validation. Run the stored sample at defined intervals. Compare the results of the stored samples with that of the original result of the same sample on the day of collection. Calculate the percent difference as the first run value minus the second run value divided by the first run value into 100. The acceptable percent difference must be defined by the lab based on the lab CV or other sources like the CLIA guidelines. Now let us take an example. A sample number ID 123 is run on 11/4/16, which is the first run, and the hemoglobin level is recorded as 11.2, TLC 5400, RBC count 4.5. The same sample is run on the next day after 24 hours on 12/4/16. This is the second run. Here, the hemoglobin values are 11.1, TLC 5600, RBC count 4.3. The difference in the hemoglobin is 0.1, which is 0.89% difference, and the acceptance criteria is less than 5%. Therefore, this run is acceptable. In TLC, the difference is 200, which is 3.7% difference, which is less than the 5% acceptance criteria. So this run is also acceptable. Similarly, in RBC, the percent difference is 4.4%, which is again less than 5% and is acceptable. Waste management. All blood samples should be discarded as per biomedical waste management rules. Waste fluids, instrument consumables, and other liquid waste materials must be disposed of after disinfecting with hypochlorite for at least 30 minutes or in accordance with local biomedical waste rules. Safety. Always wear personal protective equipment and gloves when processing with the instrument and during maintenance. After completion of work, wash hands. There is danger of contracting infection from an infectious sample or the controlled sample. The five-part analyzer uses a semiconductor laser unit. This laser unit is shielded and should not be tampered with. All equipments having pictorial hazard signs with safety warnings should be kept in mind. Make sure the reagents used with the instruments are kept at a lower level or below the main unit of the instrument. Do not put reagents on top of the instrument. Avoid direct contact with reagents. Reagents can cause irritation of the eyes, skin, and mucous membranes. Should you inadvertently come in contact with the reagent, immediately rinse skin thoroughly with water. Diluent is a good electrical conductor. If diluent is spilled near electrical cables or appliances, there is a risk of electrical shock. Switch the instrument off, unplug it, and wipe up the liquid. Cleaning solution is a strong alkaline cleaning agent. It should not come in contact with skin or clothing. Temperature requirement. Before purchase of equipment, understand the temperature requirement.